Good morning, friends. Already we have discussed in last lecture that the different figure based sum. So today we want to discuss a little bit the quadrilateral parallelogram. So it is a one type of quadrilateral that is described in a figure. So A, B, C, D is given as a quadrilateral. Now diagonal AC that is given in a question 44 meter. So AC is equal to 44 meter. And here if you will see that, here it is altitude. So perpendicular from the opposite vertex on these diagonals are 20 meter and 30 meter. So DE is equal to 20 meter. And BF is equal to 13 meter. Again I repeat, perpendicular means here 90 degree generated, and this is a vertex, D is vertex, B is also vertex, AC is a diagonal. So on AC diagonal two perpendiculars are, that is DE and BF. So AC is given, BE is given, BF is given. Now area of quadrilateral, we know that area of quadrilateral means two triangles are here, but here triangle with base and altitude. So if you will see the properly area of given field, we have to find out, then it is area of quadrilateral. So area of quadrilateral is equal to area of triangle ABC, area of triangle ABC plus area of triangle ADC. Area of quadrilateral is equal to area of ABC plus area of ADC. Now area of ABC is equal to half into base, that is AC, and altitude or height, that is BF. So half into AC into BF plus again area of ADC, base is same, so half into AC into BE. Now, if I will make common half AC outside, then in bracket BF plus DE. So, to find out the area of quadrilateral, half into diagonal plus sum of perpendicular from opposite side is equal to half into diagonal. So always remember, half into diagonal in bracket sum of perpendicular side, or we can say h1 plus h2. It is better that we can write h1 plus h2, that is two different ideas given. Now we can find out the area of quadrilateral. So area of quadrilateral is equal to, now area of quadrilateral ABCD is equal to half into diagonal, that is given 44, in bracket height h1 plus height h2, or we can say DE or FB, or we can, here it is H1, here it is H2. So that is given 20 and 30. So 20 plus 30. So if you cut this 22, so 22 in bracket, I have to write 20 plus 30, that is 33. Now you multiply yourself, you will get 20 with again 44, 20 and 30. So 44, that is 2 divided by 22, here 20. Again 13 is there, 20 plus 13, 33. 22 into 33, whatever you will get answer, that is your answer. So whenever multiply like 22 and 33, how you can do multiplication? So we can also 33 into 22. What you have to write? 6, again 6, again 6, again 6. So 6, 12, 7. So 726. 726 meter square. That is the area. That is the area of the given field. So I think it is easy when such type of sums are there. What in the question? Quadrilateral is given, and in quadrilateral two altitudes are given, or we can say height is given and one diagonal is given. So either when sides are not given at here, if you will see four sides are not given, only diagonal with altitude given, we can use this formula to find out the area of quadrilateral. So I think it is a textual based sum in text, it is in form of example, we can have understand properly. Now one more sum that is based on the parallelogram. So you will see that it will, yeah, ABCD is a parallelogram, and in parallelogram one of the important property of parallelogram is that sides are equal and parallel, opposite sides are equal and parallel. So field is in form of parallelogram has side 60 meter and 40 meter, and one of the diagonal is given. So always remember that parallelogram has equal side. So AB is equal to CD. AB is equal to CD in parallelogram, and AD is equal to BC, and one of the diagonal is given. One of the diagonal is given. That is 80 meters. So here it is. Again, it is a textual based question. 60 meter and 80 meter. Now, area, question number second. We have to find out the area of the parallelogram. To find the area of parallelogram, now area of parallelogram. Area of parallelogram, that is ABC, at here is equal to twice into area of triangle ABC. Twice into the area of triangle ABC. Area of parallelogram ABCD is equal to twice into area of ABC. So what we have to find out? Only find out the area of ABC. Why? Because in parallelogram both triangles are same area. Because parallelogram have same area, that is area of ABC is equal to area of triangle ADC. So both same area, so I have to multiply by 2. Now what is the first target? We have to write A. So here A is equal to 80 meter, B is equal to 60 meter, and C is equal to 40 meter. We can take ABC, you can take opposite A, that is 40, we can take opposite B, that is 80, opposite C, that is 60, we can take it. So now we have to find out S, that is A plus B plus C by 2. So 80 plus 60, that is 140, or we can say 60 plus 40, 100 plus 80, 180. So 180 divided by 2, that is 90 meter. Now, which formula we have to apply? Iron's formula. So, area of triangle is equal to S, S minus A, S minus B, S minus C. Now we know that the value of S, that is 90. So 90 minus 80, 90 minus 60, and 90 minus 40. Now, here, 90 into 10 into 30 into 50. So, if you will go through, we get answer 315. If we go through, we can get answer 1, 2, 3 and 4. So, 9 into 1, 2, 3 and 4. 9 into 1, 2, 3 and 4 zeros are there. So, 90,000 I have to write. 5 into 350. So, if 9,000, again, 4 zeros are there. So, as they come out as a 2 0. 9 is a perfect square of 3. So, 300 root 15 meter square is the area of one triangle. Area of one triangle, that is 300 root 15. We have to find out the area of parallelogram ABCD. So, area of parallelogram is equal to twice into area of parallelogram is equal to twice into area of ABC. So, twice into 300 root 15. So, answer is 600 root 15 meter square. So, area of parallelogram is equal to, again I repeat the such type of, it is also NCERT based sum. So, you have to understand properly how to find out area of parallelogram. When diagonal and sides are given, one of the diagonal and side are given, two sides are given. Because we know that opposite sides are equal. So, we can find out the area of one triangle. Multiply by 2, we can get area of parallelogram. Now, we have to go through the one textual based sum, that is trapezium. So, quadrilateral, rhombus, already yesterday we have discussed. Today, parallelogram also discussed. Now, we want to discuss a little bit the trapezium. So, in trapezium, one of the important characteristics from the parallelogram is that is only one pair. In trapezium, only one pair is equal. While in parallelogram, two pair is equal. So, here, one of the trapezium that we have to draw. So, here, it is a trapezium, that is A, B, C, D. So, we have to draw A, B, C and D. It is a one of the trapezium. The field is in shape of trapezium whose parallel sides are 25 parallel side. It means AB. Question number 3. AB, one of the pair is parallel, that is AB parallel to CD. AB parallel to CD. Now AB is given, that is 25. AB is equal to 25 meters. So if question is in 20 meter, then we have to write in meter. If it is in centimeter, we have to write in centimeter. Now parallel side are 25 and 10. So, CD is equal to 10 meter. The non-parallel sides are, so here it is non-parallel side. Non parallel sides. Non parallel sides are, here it is 25, here it is 10. So non parallel side, that is AB is equal to 13 and BC is equal to 14 meter. Now find the area of the field. Find the area of field. Find area of field. So it's a trapezium. So to find out the area of trapezium, ABCD is trapezium. So find out the area of trapezium. First of all, if you will see properly, important sum, it's a textual base, NCERT base sum is there. So first of all, we have to make a triangle from it. So if you will see properly, I make right E at here. So AD is parallel to B. So we can write 13 at here. We have to construct, draw a line from C. Draw a line from C which is parallel to AD. Draw a line from C on AB which is parallel to AD. The point is E. Now here it is 10. So I have to write 10 also at here. So 25 minus 10, we have to write 15. So one of the important triangle we have get, that is B, E and C. Why I have to do like that? Because in 9th standard we have understand, sorry, in 8th standard we have understand that area of trapezium is equal to half into height into sum of parallel side, that is A plus B. Or we can do it by, if you will find out the height of it, we can also get answer. So now we have to first of find out the area of triangle. So area of triangle, that is BCE. Here A is equal to, we can write 15, B is equal to, we can write 14, and C is equal to, we can write 13. So A 15, B 14, C 13. By using Heron's formula, first of all, we have to find out S. That is 15 plus 14 plus 13 divided by 2. So that is 42. 42 divided by 2. 42 divided by 2, that is 21 meter. So S is equal to 21 meter. Now, by using Heron's formula, we have to find out the area of triangle. So area of triangle is equal to under root 21, 21 minus 15, 21 minus 14, and 21 minus 13. So 21 into 6 into 7 into 8. So 21 into 6 into 7 into 8. Now if you multiply here, 21. Here we can do 21. Why? 21 into 2 into 3 into 7 into 8. So now 21 into 21 into 16. 21, 7 to the 21, 8 to the 16. Now 21 is 2 times. So we can take outside. So 21 into 16 is a 4. So 84 meter square. Area of this triangle is 84 meter square. 84 meter square. That is the area of BCE. Triangle BCE area is equal to 84 meter square. Now why I have to find out? Because to compare with area is equal to height into base. So we can find out height and then we can apply in trapezium's formula. So trapezium formula is sum of the half into height into sum of parallel side, we can get answer. So 84, now I have to compare 84. Two things we can do it. Either we can find out from here. So first of all, we have to find out the height. So make dark at here. We can say H, and we have to name it F. So now area is equal to half into BF, sorry, BE into CF. So area is equal to 84 is equal to half BE. Yeah, that is 15 into CF. So CF is equal to 84 into 2 divided by 15. So 8168 upon 15. That is our height. So height here, it is, that is 168 upon 15. We can cancel it. We can do it by 3. 3 5s are, 3 2s are 6, 3 8s are. So we can write 56 upon 5. So CF is equal to 56 upon 5. Now we concentrate on area of trapezium. So area of trapezium is equal to 1 by 2 into height, that is CF, into sum of parallel side, that is AB, plus CD. So 1 by 2 into 56 by 5 and 25 plus 10. Into 35. So we can cut it by 7 and here 28. So 28 into 7, that is 196 meter square. So area of trapezium is 196 meter square. So again I explained fully this sum. What first the trapezium is given. In trapezium we have to find out by using formula, area of trapezium is equal to half into height into sum of parallel side. Here height is not given in question and we have to find out height. How we can find out height? We have to make a triangle in one trapezium. So what is the first plan? From C point, one line parallel to AD, that is point E. So we have constructed one triangle B, E and C. So here it is 10, so A is also 10. AD is parallel to CE, so here it is 13, again it is 13. So 13, 13, 10, 10, it's a parallelogram. And here one triangle. So we have find out by using Hero's formula area of triangle, that is 84 meter square. Now I have to compare second step. Area of triangle is equal to half into CF into base BE. So base is now 24 minus 10, that is 15. So base is 15 into. So we can find out height, that is 56 by 5 meter. That we have to put in the formula and we can get value related area of trapezium. So mostly I have completed the sum. Now still some figure based sums are there. So in next lecture we can discuss more three figure. So if you have some doubt related with question, you can send me in WhatsApp number.